theory of change allows us to precisely define what the intervention is trying to target, how that relates to outcomes, and then what we might expect in terms of variations in who's most likely to benefit, who might be less likely to benefit.
The FOI model of theory of change includes four components. The first is the program strategies. So these are the actions and activities that comprise a given program. The second are the targets, which are the skills, behavior, knowledge, et cetera, that the program hopes to promote or enhance through the intervention. The third are the outcomes. These are kind of the ultimate outcomes, the meaningful changes in functioning and quality of life that we hope to see for the kids and caregivers who participate in programs. And then the fourth component are moderators, which are factors that are hypothesized to be associated with either sort of better or poorer outcomes for a given participant.
When we start working with a team, there are often a lot of ideas about what the goals of a program should be. Often the goals are really the way we think about outcomes. So we want children to be able to get along with their peers better and to be able to solve problems when they come up better. And that's a great thing to work on. But the question is, what is your intervention going to do to help the child get to that place? So if you think about this in terms of dominoes, what's the first domino that you push over to help children become more able to solve problems? Maybe they need some basic skills to address when the conflict comes up, how to begin to approach it in a way that doesn't escalate the situation. Learning those skills is a target, and being able to show that the child has acquired those skills would be an example of something that we might help a team figure out as part of the process in terms of, okay, this is what the target is, and now we can figure out how to measure that.
Each round of implementation and evaluation is an opportunity to learn more about the way the program is working in real-world settings and to continually refine both the program and your understanding of it.
Often, the process is one of distilling what people already have in mind as a very clear, kind of intuitive set of ideas, but where it's not necessarily as clear to them exactly how those things might fit into a very clearly defined theory of change.